Borthakur IAS Academy, an endeavor of excellence.
Borthakur IAS Academy.
Hello everyone, welcome to Borthakur's IAS Academy, Northeast's premier institute for UPSC and APSC preparation. Today we will be analyzing some of the important news from the Assam Tribune dated 2nd April 2021 along with some other important news. Please like and share this video and also don't forget to subscribe to our channel. In the description box below, we have provided the link for the e-paper so that you can download it from there. The first news of today is a news of concern from the international relation perspective. Okay, the influx of refugees from Myanmar at the Indian and Thai borders is ominous. Ominous is a negative word which means inauspicious or gloomy. Okay, and recently the Ministry of Home Affairs, MHA, has directed the states of Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram and Arunachal Pradesh to check the illegal influx from Myanmar into India. This has come as a direct result after the military coup. Due to forcefully military, it took over the government, okay, and there is political unrest in Myanmar. It was Janu, we have discussed this news before, okay. The Tatmadaw or the military, Myanmar military, Jakwahoy, they have taken over the country after a coup in the month of February 2021. And Tarpisa, several people, because of the subsequent crackdown, okay, and the unrest, political and social unrest, because of that, several people, they have crossed over, okay, they have came into the across the border of India. Aru yar agoteo Rohingya refugees of Lopelai, India, bohut besi problem, India face koriye asile, okay. As per the estimate, in the year 2020, around 40,000 Rohingya refugees are found scattered across various states of India. And specifically, geographically, jodi ami sound, tetia hole Myanmar and India states shares the border, okay. And jitu bordering area hai tat Mizoram, Manipur, Arunachal Pradesh, aru Nagaland, ei kekhon states ase. And yate sobotke besi illegal immigrants ho ase from Myanmar. Mizoramor logot Arunachal Pradesh or logot sobotke besi distance share hoy, okay. Mizoram shares 510 km and Arunachal Pradesh shares 520 km. And all together, covering all these four states, India and Myanmar shares a border of 1,643 kilometers. Because in the bordering areas, the people of both the nations, okay, they have some cultural similarities, okay. Aru ei cultural similarities or logote family relations ase across the border areas, and this has resulted in providing a sympathetic view to those who have fled from Myanmar. Aru he karne ihata teoloko shelter u diya hoise, thik ase, kisuman bordering areas or he karne shelter provide kara hoise. And already because of certain tribes like the Bru, okay, there is a lot of clashes among the natives and this tribal people. Aru further refugees jodi ahe aru besi influx jodi hoy, then this is going to further aggravate the situation, and also this is going to have a negative impact on the Indo-Myanmar relationship. And next, here you can see the border sharing, okay, between India and Myanmar. Aruma mentioned korisu is that Mizoram, Manipur, Nagaland and parts of Arunachal Pradesh shares border with Myanmar, okay. India and Myanmar total border distance hoy hetu hoise 1,643 kilometers, and a sarikhon state divide hoy ase, and because of this yar jitu border hoy, okay. One more important point is that the border along all the four states are unfenced, okay. Kunu dhoroner permanent inko fencing nai, and these are porous. So yar pura manhu border cross korte iman besi difficulty hoy. Yar logote eta free movement regime ase which exists between the India and Myanmar. Aru under this particular movement, every member of the hill tribe who is either a citizen of India or Myanmar, who is a resident of an area within 16 kilometers. Yare hill tribes or manukhine 16 kilometer bitor jodi both the sides of border bitor jodi 16 kilometer or himat teoluk thake tetia hale Indo Myanmar border যিটো এরিয়া হয় তার যদি 16 কিলোমিটার ইফাল ইফালর সীমাত তেওঁলোক থাকে তেতিয়া হলে দে ক্যান ক্রস দ্য বর্ডার উইথ অনলি আ বর্ডার পাস ওকে এন্ড দ্যাট পার্টিকুলার পাস হ্যাজ আ ওয়ান ইয়ার ভ্যালিডিটি সো উইথ দ্যাট পাস দে ক্যান they can cross the border, okay? And this has been issued by a competent, by the competent authority, and they can stay there up to 2 weeks per visit. Ebar hekonor validity 1 year hoy, but once they get that card, okay, and if they visit across the border, they can stay for a period of like maximum 2 weeks. So, এইবিলাক এনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ মুভমেণ্টছৰ কাৰণেও ইট বিকামছ ডিফিকাল্ট টু কণ্ট্ৰল দিছ ইনফ্লাক্স আৰু এতিয়া যিহেতু তাতে টেনশ্যন বাঢ়ি গৈছে দিছ ইজ কুৱাইট অবভিয়াছ যে তাৰ পৰা ৰোহিংগিয়াৰ লগতে আৰু বেছি ফৰেইনাৰ্ছ বা আৰু বেছি মানে তাৰ নেটিভছ ইয়ালৈকে মাইগ্ৰেট হ'ব এণ্ড উই উইল হেভ টু চেক ইট বিকজ দিছ ইজ গোয়িং টু পুট ফাৰ্ডাৰ মোৰ ষ্ট্ৰেছ অন আৱাৰ ষ্টেটছ অন আৱাৰ কাণ্ট্ৰি The next news is regarding 17th BIMSTEC ministerial meeting where our External Affairs Minister of India, Dr. S. Jayashankar, participated through a virtual mode and also it was attended by all the BIMSTEC member states. This particular 17th meeting was chaired by Sri Lanka. So before that, discussing about this 17th BIMSTEC ministerial meeting, let us have a look at the what BIMSTEC is, okay? What is BIMSTEC? It is the Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multi-Sectoral, Technical and Economic Cooperation. And it is a regional multilateral organization, okay? Yeah, members kun kun hoy? Hatta total member ase, okay? Hatta total member or bitor or Pascon nations are from South Asia and the other two are from Southeast Asia. So South Asia nations kekhon hoise Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Nepal, Sri Lanka and Southeast Asia hoise participants Myanmar aru Thailand okay yar arambhoni hoisile genesis to starting origin it is this particular organization it came into force in 1997 through the Bangkok declaration initially yar saita member states asile aru yar acronym to etia jitu BIMSTEC hoy etu agote asile BISTEC okay that were those were Bangladesh India Sri Lanka and Thailand economic cooperation after participation of Myanmar and Nepal yar naam to change kori diya hol and it was named as the Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multi-Sectoral, Technical and Economic Cooperation. Bay of Bengal Initiative boli ekarne kua hoise because all the nations, okay, they lie geographically, they look Bay of Bengal or surroundings are located hoy, right? Aruma map ekhon yate dekhaisu. এইটো চালে আপোনালোকে দেখিব পাৰিব কেনেকৈ থাইলেণ্ড ম্যানমাৰ ভূটান বাংলাদেশ নেপাল এজ ৱেল এজ ইণ্ডিয়া অ'কে এণ্ড শ্ৰীলংকা অলছো চ' ৱাট ইজ কমন ইন অল দিছ কাণ্ট্ৰিজ দেট ইজ বে অফ বেংগল দেটছ ৱাই দ নেম বে অফ বেংগল ইনিচিয়েটিভ ফৰ মাল্টি চেক্টৰেল টেকনিকেল এণ্ড ইকনমিক কোঅপাৰেশ্যন আৰু ইয়াৰ মেইন অবজেক্টিভ অফ দিছ পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ অৰ্গেনাইজেশ্যন ইজ টু create a enabling environment for rapid economic development in this particular region it will also encourage equality and partnership of the participatory regions and also other developing economies okay this will also promote active collaboration and mutual assistance among the member countries which in turn will accelerate the processes that were going on in the field of education science and tech etc now moving back to this 17th BIMSTEC ministerial meeting a meeting khonot ki ki topics discuss kara hoisile aru tar kisman ki results jikini ulaise aru tar next upcoming ki plans hoy ei member countries ketar hekini bikhoye mo apoman briefly koi disu firstly our external minister okay dr s jayashankar he pressurized on india's commitment towards building the cooperation okay regional cooperation among the member nations and also highlighted the progress which was achieved under india's leadership okay gute kekhon member countries or bitorot kesuman enikua initiatives asile jot india as a lead country asile aru he topics pur hoise counter terrorism and transnational crime transport and communication tourism and environmental and disaster management these are some of the activities okay which were taken by India, which were undertaken by India to deepen the cooperation among the member countries. Okay. And next, jitu point hai, this is regarding the endorsement of master plan for transport connectivity, okay, which will be adopted in the next BIMSTEC summit. Okay. Aru tar logote tinta MOU, Memorandum of Understanding, will also be signed. Hetur bishoye discuss kara hoise, and it is also planned that the next upcoming summit will be held in Sri Lanka in the next few months with the proper consultation of the member states. Okay. আৰু তাৰ নেক্সটটো হৈছে যে ইয়াত ডিজাষ্টাৰ মেনেজমেণ্টৰ কাৰণে আৰ্লি ডিজাষ্টাৰ ৱাৰ্নিং ফেচিলিটিজ প্ৰভাইড কৰা হ'ব. অ'কে, এই মিটিংটোত ৱেডাৰ এণ্ড ক্লাইমেটৰ ওপৰত ফ'কাছ কৰা হৈছিলে, উইচ ৱাজ বিং হোষ্টেড বাই ইণ্ডিয়া. আৰু ইয়াৰ লগতে ফুল্লি ফাংচনেল ফেচিলিটিজ প্ৰভাইড কৰা হ'ব, উইচ উইল প্ৰভাইড আৰ্লি ডিজাষ্টাৰ ৱাৰ্নিংছ. অ'কে, চ' ডেট হেজাৰ্ড মেপিং, আৰ্লি মিটিগেশ্যন, ৰিস্ক ৰিডাকশ্যন এণ্ড মিটিগেশ্যন ইয়াত হেল্প হয়. So these were the few things which were discussed. Aru tar logote last jitu summit hoisile tat amar India's honorable prime minister e jikini implement korisile service initiatives or kotha jikini implementation of kora hoise hekini appreciate kora hoise, right? So these were the main things which were discussed in the 17th BIMSTEC ministerial meeting. Next, let us have a look at the Indo-Bangladesh relationship and the updates after the recent visit of Indian Prime Minister to Bangladesh on 26th and 27th of March. He joined the celebrations of the Golden Jubilee of Independence of Bangladesh, right, along with the birth centenary of Bangladesh's father of nation, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, who is also known as Bangabandhu. This also marks 50 years of establishment of diplomatic relations between India and Bangladesh. And one more important point is that India conferred the Gandhi Peace Prize 2020 to Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. It was a prelims or karne important question hobo pare, or else it can also be important for other competitive exams. So we all know that Bangladesh is one of the India's neighboring countries, right? And India shares the longest international border with Bangladesh, and the length of Indo-Bangladesh border is 4096.7 kilometer. Itu eta important question hoy je which nation shares the longest, India shares the longest international border with which nation? It is Bangladesh. Okay, aru jekhini ei last jitu visit asile tar updates hoy hetu moy ketar ketaman important points moy koi disu. It obviously, first one is it marked the 50th anniversary of diplomatic relations of India and Bangladesh. Okay, and second to hoise signing of certain memorandum of understanding. It was based on the field of disaster management, resilience and mitigation, then national cadet corps of both Bangladesh and India. Okay, the third one was establishment of framework of cooperation in the area of trade remedial measures between Bangladesh and India. Enekua dhoronor kisuman development hoise aru tar logote both the prime ministers, they announced the release of Bangladesh friendship stamps. Okay, to commemorate this particular event, dukhon nation e stamps release korise to establish their bilateral diplomatic ties. Okay, aru yar logote Bangladeshot foundation stone lay kara hoise to honor the martyrs of Indian armed forces who sacrificed their lives during the liberation war of 1971 jot Bangladesh was formed. Okay, and Pakistan was divided. Pakistan or bifurcate hoi pelai, West Pakistan remained Pakistan, and due to East Pakistan asile, it was named as Bangladesh, and it became a separate independent nation. Okay, aru border huts inaugurate kara hoise Nalikata India side on aru Saidabad Bangladesh or side on tinikhon border huts, mane border markets. Okay, they were inaugurated. Aru also a passenger train service known as Mitali Express is inaugurated. It covers the distance from New Jalpaiguri to Dhaka. Okay, and this will be en route Chilahati and Haldibari rail link. The next news is regarding vaccine wastage and its prevention. Okay, ami janwe je the vaccine drive, it has already started. Aru etia 45 years and above population hoy teluko vaccinate kara hoise, the world's largest vaccination program began in India on January 16th, 2021. Okay, and this particular vaccination drive, it is India is entering a decisive phase of vaccination to fight against the COVID-19. Okay, and this has made with two made in India COVID-19 vaccines. Ami hei duta vaccine or naam jano, Covishield and Covaxin, right? Now during this vaccination drive, ami agote agor news analysis of ami discuss korisilu regarding the vaccine diplomacy of India. Okay, how India is going to gift some amount of the vaccines to the neighboring as well as to other countries who cannot afford this, particular like developing countries who cannot afford vaccinating their entire population, so they are gifting. And recently jitu Indian Prime Minister Bangladesh le goisile, okay, so there also a part of the vaccination, okay, it was gifted. Around 38 lakhs of vaccines were gifted. The next news is on the vaccine wastage and its prevention, right? So in India, the first vaccination drive for COVID-19, which is also supposed to be the world's largest vaccination program, it started on January 16, 2021. This was approved with two made in India COVID-19 vaccines. Aru heketar naam hoise Covishield and Covaxin, right? Covishield by Serum Institute of India and Covaxin by the Bharat Biotech. Etia, along with this vaccination drive, okay, we also have to make sure of two things. One is the prevention of vaccine wastage, okay, and next is awareness among the population. India is not only vaccinating its entire population. We all know that India is the second most populated nation of the world, right? Along with it, India is also engaged in vaccine diplomacy. Etu bikhoye moi agor analysis of discuss korisil je how India is helping other nations, along with the neighboring nations, also other underdeveloped nations, and maybe certain European nations as well, in like they are providing vaccines. India is providing vaccines to those countries who are in need. Aru recently Prime Minister or jitu Bangladesh le visit asile, tateo a part of the vaccine that has been sent from India, a part of it is gifted. Okay, hetu charges lua hua nai. And India has always been quite active in the field of medicines and vaccines, because 80 to 90% of the entire world's measles vaccine is provided by India, right? And India is also supplying the rubella vaccines to South America. So India has been quite active in this state, because we believe in humanity, we believe in development as a whole. Okol amar nationote hei bemar tu root korile nohobo, entire world of jetia jikuno eta bemar komibo tetia he we will also be safe, because this is a disease, it does not see like international borders, right? So we will have to be kind enough, we will have to maintain humanitarian relations with our neighbor countries and also with others, okay, so that we can fight this evil together. Aru tar karone mass jitu awareness, it is very important, especially in case of COVID-19 vaccine, because this is a new vaccine, right? And we don't know how it is going to affect our body. Vaccine has got different reactions to different people depending on their immunity and their like their body, right? So that particular awareness, that particular belief is very important. Aru ebar bishekhe, since India is going to populate its entire population, also it will be engaged in vaccine diplomacy. So the government, the center, has strictly provided certain guidelines to the states to in order to follow during the vaccination drive, which is to maintain vaccine wastage of wastage at less than 1%. All up to mane wastage hoboy, which is quite obvious because of human errors, okay? So he karane eta particular range thori dise je of the total amount okol 1% aru tatkeo kom hai hobo pare. You should be very careful, but even if something happens, then that should not exceed 1%. But at present, the national wastage percentage is around 6%. Okay, আৰু এই যিটো ভেকচিন ৱেষ্টেজ হয় ইট ইজ এন আনএক্সপেক্টেড কম্পনেণ্ট অ'কে ইমান ডাঙৰ ভেকচিনেশ্যন যিটো ড্ৰাইভ চৰি দিছ ইজ এন এক্সপেক্টেড কম্পনেণ্ট ইমান ডাঙৰ এটা ভেকচিনেশ্যন যিটো ড্ৰাইভ হয় তাত এটা মানে ইমান বেছি পপুলেশ্যন একেলগে ভেকচিনেট কৰিব লাগিব পিপল আৰ অলছ' নট ভেৰি ইউ নো কিন টু ডু দিছ এট ফাৰ্ষ্ট দে আৰ অলৱেজ ৰিলাকটেণ্ট কেনেকুৱা বা হয় কাৰ কাৰণে ভাল সঁচা কৈছে নাই কোৱা এনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ বহুত কথা থাকে ৰাইট চ' সেইকাৰণে দিছ ইজ কুৱাইট অবভিয়াছ আৰু ডিফাৰেণ্ট ষ্টেজেছ আছে য'ত ভেকচিনেশ্যনৰ এই ভেকচিনছবিলাকৰ ৱেষ্টেজ হ'ব পাৰে ক'ল্ড চেইন পইণ্টছ য'ত ভালকৈ ষ্ট'ৰেজ কৰিব পাৰে ৰাইট চ' সেইখিনি জেগাতে যদি কিবা প্ৰব্লেম হয় চ' ডেট মাইট অলছো result in like proper jodi storage facility na thake that might result in wastage district vaccine stores jibilak stores or deliver hoy hekini samayot during the process of transport okay that might also result in certain wastage okay our vaccination session site took to hoboy pare because ketiaba kisuman patients they are like very afraid and reluctant to take the vaccine লৈ যোৱা হয় জোৰ জবৰদস্তি বাট দেন দে ৰিটেলিয়েট এণ্ড দিছ মাইট ৰিজাল্ট ইন চাৰ্টেইন লছ এণ্ড ৱেষ্টেজ অফ ভেকচিনেশ্যন এট দ্য চাইট নেক্সট লেট এছ হেভ এ লুক এট দ্য কেপচুল নিউজ উইচ আৰ ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট ফ্ৰম প্ৰিলিমছ পাৰ্স্পেক্টিভ নাম্বাৰ ওৱান ইজ শ্বাটিং ডাউন অফ মিলিটাৰী ফাৰ্মছ দিজ মিলিটাৰী ফাৰ্মছ দে ৱেৰ ষ্টাৰ্টেড ফৰ প্ৰভাইডিং হাইজেনিক কাউ মিল টু দ্য ট্ৰুপছ একৰছ ব্ৰিটিছ ইণ্ডিয়া পাৰ্টিশ্যনৰ চৰি ইণ্ডিপেণ্ডেন্সৰ আগতে start hoisile ei military farms were which were allotted with the responsibility of providing fresh and hygienic cow milk aru first jitu military farm asile it was raised in Allahabad okay at Allahabad on 1st of february 1889 aru etial leke 132 years of service dile and then there was a formal closing ceremony which was held recently and it marked the closing of this military farms আৰু এই মিলিটাৰী ফাৰ্মছবিলাকে ইন দ্য লেট 1990s দে ষ্টাৰ্টেড প্ৰভাইডিং চাৰ্ভিচেছ এণ্ড ৱেৰ এষ্টাব্লিছড ইভেন ইন দ্য লেহ এণ্ড কাৰ্গিল ৰিজনছ অ'কে চ' মেইন যিটো ৰিজন হয় এইবিলাকৰ শ্বাটডাউনৰ কাৰণে ইট ইনক্লুডছ দেট ইট বিকামছ ভেৰি ডিফিকাল্ট ফৰ লেণ্ড ট্ৰেক মেনেজমেণ্ট অফ দ্য ডিফেন্স প্লেন এণ্ড প্ৰডাকশ্যন এণ্ড চাপ্লাই প্ৰডাকশ্যন অফ মিল্ক এণ্ড চাপ্লাই অফ হে টু দিছ animals okay so iman dangor tract of land manage kori pelai tar cattle bilakok healthy rakhar daitto telokok manage kara daitto etu luatu alop dikdar hoy goisile and because of that this was the main reason why it was shut down in the year 2012 itself a branch was recommended okay for their closure aru yar significance ase ei military farms pur bahut beshi helpful asile in like when they were running okay so it provided around 3.5 crore liters of milk yearly okay and main service they also provide korisile during the 1971 war and also it provided milk at the western and eastern war fronts during the Kargil war operations and the next news is regarding AIM Prime Atal Innovation Mission program for researchers on innovations market readiness and entrepreneurship This is launched by NITI Aayog okay and it is an initiative to promote and support science based deep tech startups and ventures across India in this regard itself Atal Innovation Mission has also joined hands with Bill and Me India Gates Foundation to launch this nationwide program which will be implemented by Venture Center which is a non profit technology business incubator This program is open to the senior incubation managers of the AIM funded Atal incubation centers that are supporting the deep tech entrepreneurs and the benefits of this program are aimed at addressing scientific issues and through training and guidance over a period of around 12 months now let us have a look at the questions for today question number 1 discuss the contributions of MSMEs to GDP number 2 where is the headquarters of BIMSTEC why is it important for India number 3 what are the main factors responsible for gender inequality in India discuss the contribution of Savitribai Phule in this regard question number 4 climate change overexploitation and policy measures have combinedly turned India into a water stressed economy discuss question number 5 how will the melting of Himalayan glaciers have a far reaching impact on the water resources of India So this was all for today. Thank you so much for watching this session. Please like and share this video and also don't forget to subscribe to our channel. I'll see you all tomorrow again with another session of newspaper analysis only at Borthakur's IAS Academy, Northeast's premier institute for UPSC and APSC preparations. Till then, take care and keep learning. Bye-bye.
Borthakur IAS Academy. Prastuti aru adhyayanor nirbharjoggo thikona. Borthakur IAS Academy.